moving forward with this story.
Controlling the game from the centre of the ground.
Good evening and welcome to Off the Bench. Thanks to McDonald's and the TAC. Of course, speeding drivers are the biggest killers on our road. Well, it's our penultimate show. I knew I'd muck that up, Plough. As I say, good evening to Terry Wallace. And grand finals, upsets, it's all happening in country footy.
Yeah, thanks, Pickers. I love this time of the year. It doesn't matter whether it's the AFL or all the country leagues. And my team, the Pigeons, just got up again.
The Pigeons. Oh, we're going to talk more about them as well. But it's time straight off the top to introduce the good-looking man from Win TV, Shawnee Sowerby. And Shawnee, there were plenty of upsets as well.
There certainly were. And it's in our blood, being Australians, that we always seem to barrack for the underdog. And the underdog well and truly got up with the Ballara Demons in the Mid-Gippsland Football League Grand Final. They won their first flag in 14 years, knocking off back-to-back Premier Trafalgar by 28 points.
A lot of blokes that have played there have got belting after belting every week, every year, and it's for them just as much as it is for us.
The club's been, like, we've been in the bottom, we've been whacked for years and years and years. So to come from second bottom to obviously win, or to be in a position where we could win, we were sort of happy with that, but we thought we really need to give something back.
Amazing upset, an amazing achievement, and Ballara, well, they were fantastic. Andrew Thorpe and Michael Cleaver each booted three goals for the winners. It was one of the biggest upsets in Mid-Gippsland Football League history. And to think about it, this is a club which was heavily affected in the Black Saturday bushfires too.
Well, that's the thing that I love about this story, just the fact that going back 3 years ago, they were the youngest side virtually going around, had all 18-year-olds playing with them, and the fact that they stuck together and have come through and won a flag's a great effort.
I'll tell you what, I reckon Trafalgar were in trouble from the time they put that banner up. That was the smallest banner I've ever seen. You nearly had to go through single file.
Well, 28 points is a big margin coming up against a team that was going for three in a row, and congratulations to Ballara. That's a fantastic win, and the town will be going absolutely crazy at the moment.
It is a lovely time of the year, the footy finals. I mean, the whole towns get involved, don't they? I mean, it's great to watch. Yeah, everyone, as I say, there's streamers in the windows and all that sort of stuff as well. I think it's a fantastic time of the year.
And the fact with Ballara, I mean, only their fourth flag in the history of the footy club, I mean, that goes down forever. So, yeah, great effort.
Absolutely. Well done to them. Now, let's get to the Colac and District Grand Final. Another thriller.
It happened on Saturday. It was an absolutely spectacular win. Now, the Birregurra Saints, it was a case of third-time lucky, that had played in the last two grand finals, lost both of them. But they ended up winning a thriller by an amazing 3 points against South Colac. The celebrations were massive.
So much work gone in and so much effort, starting from the smallest bloke of the club right through to the biggest club. And, you know, the president, you know, everyone that's been involved, like, this is a real town victory. Like, it's not just a Birregurra Football Club, it's a real town victory. So, you know, like I've said, I'm so proud.
You don't play these days to come second, especially that close. Like, we've had our chance. They've had three more scoring shots. There's a few rushed there. So, yeah, your words can't describe it.
Now, it's Birregurra's first flag in 17 years, their fourth flag in the club's history. It was a fantastic win. It came right down to the wire. Now, they were up by 8 points, Birregurra, but they had hardly anyone on the bench with your mate, Paul Lynch.
Oh, Paul Lynch. Look at him. There he is with the hands up in the air. Lynchy, the coach. He's was a very good player. But when I'm looking at my running sheet, Plough, and you remember Paul Lynch, he was a very good player for the Cats. When I read here, it says he's tore his hamstring. Lynchy, you're too old, mate. You were tearing hamstrings when you were 21.
And how nervous must have they been in that last quarter? You're in front, all of a sudden the opposition kicked the last couple of goals.
And the way they did it, Terry, have a look at that. That's Jace Kelly, the best on ground for Birregurra. Two 50-metre penalties with basically 10 minutes to go. They got two goals out of it, South Colac. And Birregurra, if it wasn't for this goal here, they could have got done.
You'd be just sitting there sort of, as a supporter going, don't tell me it's going to happen again.
Gee whiz, I'm going to tell you what, there was a bit of a slowness coming out of the back line there by the South Colac defender.
Heavy conditions, and I suppose he tried to get a bit extra on that kick, but South Colac captain Clay Brewer was best on ground for the Kangaroos, but they just fell just short. But a great performance for the year, seeing as they didn't make the finals the year before.
Yeah, very well done there to the boys at Birregurra. Seriously, Lynchy, you're too old, mate. Just coach. No, he was a very good player, mate.
He was a very good player.
He had 1997 for the Cats. He single-handedly, when he got injured, we knew nearly went straight out of the finals because of it. Anyhow, that's enough about you, Lynchy. Now, Warburg, tell us about what's going on there.
In the Central Highlands Football League, well, most clubs would be happy to win one grand final. It's an amazing achievement, especially for a town with a population of 494 people. But the Warburg Kangaroos, they not only won the seniors against Dalesford in the Central Highlands, they also won the reserves and the under-18s. Clayton Scoble kicked two goals for Dalesford, but Kangaroos forward Tony Mirabella also kicked two with the match sealer, and Warburg's Aaron Gleeson was best on ground, winning the Jeff Taylor medal.
It's a really good performance, isn't it? To get three teams over the line in the one season is a remarkable effort.
What also is remarkable is that there's a lot of teams wearing that kangaroo uniform.
Every
vision we see is either wearing the Kangaroos uniform or...
Yeah. There's been a lot of clubs which are the Kangaroos having fantastic victories. And for the under-18s, well, they beat Learmonth by 19 points, and the reserves, they beat Springbank by 33 points. But really, for a club to get of that size of town, to get three teams into grand finals and to win them all in the football, that's fantastic.
Yeah, no doubt, and a credit to the football club. They got in front early in this game, and with the weather turning a little bit nasty in the second half, it was pretty difficult to come from behind, but they got the job done well.
I tell you what, I love that there where you see how big, many people are at the actual game, and then you see that the bit of vision and it says Canbar. I love it when they always everyone has a Canbar, which is fantastic.
And $42,600 on the gate taking is fantastic, almost a record. And for those conditions, it just shows you that the whole of Warburg were there, plus plenty of other people.
What sort of crowd does that equate to?
The thing around about 6,000 to 7,000, which is pretty impressive. That's right. And that's not including that money in the alcohol or the canteen either. So it's a lot of money to be had from the grand final.
Certainly would have been a lot of money out of that can bar that I saw there that looked like it was chock-a-block. Now, this is one of my favourite parts of the whole year, getting to our best football and all that sort of stuff. But the country footy best and fairest fashions, look, Shawnee, let's put it in perspective here. There's a fair variance between the various leagues.
A bit of a discrepancy, but we had a chat to two AFL stars, two North Melbourne stars, Boomer Harvey and Drew Petrie, and they said they attended the Ballarat Football League's Henderson medal. They said that was a better night than the Brownlow medal.
Oh, mate, right up there. This is actually a better night. The Brownlow's pretty boring, to tell you the truth. So at least a few of the younger boys are on the gas and having a few laughs, which is a little bit better.
The Brownlow's got obviously a lot of formalities and it's you're stuck in your seat a fair bit, but I do enjoy going. I'm going again this year to the Brownlow, so it's great to come back here and to see a lot of old faces, some old teammates, old coaches.
So there you have, this is the Ballarat Football League to start off, Pickers, and that was a bit of a formal occasion.
That was the ladies all there done up. Good to see Drewy and Boomer there, and all the girls have all done up. I mean, people in suits, they've got... jackets on player. That's a nice looking crowd.
I was actually up in Ballarat for that function 12 months ago. So, look, it has a bit of everything. I know this young gentleman pretty well. Mark Alvey coached him at the Western Bulldogs.
From Wentworth, he took it out in Sunraysia.
Looking in good fashion there, Alves.
What was the Murray sort of setup here?
A bit more of a smart casual, would you say? But it seems like the most underdressed of the whole lot is the bloke that ends up winning it in each of them. That was the Murray Football League. Now, the Western Border, it's hoodies and polos.
Not hoodies. It was just a collar job, surely. Who won that award?
That was fantastic. It was joint winners. Brian Hennessy, the medal, went to Brad Vassell from Castleton and Simon Burkfield. Great result for Brad Vassell, who was a flying in player, so he was living in South Australia, flying in for each game as well. And to win that award, it's pretty impressive.
Well, Pickers, normally the polos are on because you're looking after the sponsors.
Yeah.
I didn't actually see any sponsors.
No
there.
Sponsors. Unless Polo Ralph Lauren was sponsoring some of those teams, which I'd be very surprised. Still always good fun. Now it's time for one of our favourite segments, Bush Legends.
It's time for this week's Bush Legends for SunGold, Country Fresh SunGold Milk.
And this week's Bush Legend is Gerald Jed Towler, who's played 8 years at the Berrigan Football Club in the Pocola North West Football League. The Berrigan Saints defeated Gerildery by 31 points in last weekend's grand final, winning its first senior premiership. Apparently, when we put out the call for Bush Legends, they write back he's a fair dinkum Bush legend, at just 29 years of age, and he's also a shearer by profession.
A shearer?
Yes.
Well, he's got it all covered, hasn't he?
Yeah.
Now, Plough, thanks to our great friends at Country Racing Victoria, you can book your end-of-the-season trip at a Team of the Turf Country Race Day. Marquee start from just $20. So jump onto the website there at countryracing.com.au to all the details of a great day out. And now, as we head to the break, let's have a look at Cobram celebrating their preliminary final win last week over Finlay.
It's time for Celebration of the Week. for Country Racing Victoria.
It's time for the spray of the week for Home Timber and Hardware.
The proper hardware store.
All of that lifted. They started getting frustrated. They started going the man. But fellas, we don't duck it. We don't get sucked in for that.
Ball,
we
boys.
Continue to go the football.
Come on, boys.
Getting first and get it.
Come
get
on.
The handball. So force it forward. Our forwards are winning the contest. So get it in there nice and quick.
Come on.
If we've got the ball in the centre, fellas, I don't want shit kicks out the wings. Okay, get it inside 50. Get it inside 50, fellas. 25 minutes.
How much
hard, gut running.
Sure. Hey,
fellas,
want, boys?
We've got to do it.
Come on.
It's not about wanting now. Do! Let's go! Go!
Well, there you go. Ryan Tierney from Wirrumal there. And thanks to Home Timber and Hardware, Ryan's won himself a $200 gift card. Now, it's one of the favourite times of the show for most of the viewers because First Lady time, First Lady of the Bush, Roz Lanigan joins us from the Weekly Times. And Roz, you love this time of the year. This is when you shine.
I do. You
really get out of your element.
Cover some K's, that's for sure. There's plenty of games to watch.
Well, where are we going to start? Because you've got a pretty interesting story I want to get to reasonably quickly. I think we might do it off the top.
Rightio, let's do it off the top then. Because we've seen a number of athletes this year who have crossed from rugby league or from basketball to AFL. But former Olympic diver Dean Puller last weekend got the call up for senior footy for the Cobram Tigers in the Murray Football League. And he's... pictured here, playing.
Yeah, he kicked it going. He had an impact for the Tigers, which was fantastic. He helped Finley to he helped Cobram thrash Finley by 58 points in the Murray Football League prelim final. What, Terry, tell us what sort of characteristics would help from being a diver to a footballer?
Well, his athletic prowess for a start. You can sort of see that he's not carrying any weight. He had the Eddie Betts shorts on there for
did.
A minute,
yeah,
Pickers.
He
certainly did. He was a. We won. Third, he got a bronze medal at the Olympics.
Yeah.
So he's going all right. How did he actually go? Did he get a kick?
Yeah, he got a kick to goal. I think he spent most of the year in the reserves, hasn't he? And he got a call up for the prelim on the weekend. So obviously needed, you know, another experienced player, and he did the job.
Well, you diving, it's all about timing, isn't it? So he's timed his run very, very well.
Yeah, there was no Matty Lloyd sort of diving going on, was there?
No.
That sort of stuff.
And if Spud was here, he'd probably say spatial awareness.
And the Cobram Tigers will always help them get into the grand final against the Denny Rams. So that's at Tycho Mall at 2:30, which will be a ripper.
Yep.
And he's 38 years old, so he's no spring chicken, but his body must be fantastic after all that flexibility training.
That sounds to me like a GWS recruit.
Well, he looks a good Nick. He's not carrying much. He hasn't spent a lot of time in the gym, but he's looking pretty good all the time.
And won a bronze medal in the Sydney Olympics.
Yeah. Oh, well, what are you, first Pete, now repeat. I just said that.
Yeah.
Come on, tune in.
I'm talking.
Worry about what you're going to say all the time. And good luck to James McDonald, too. Well done to Jimmy McDonald from Ballarat, of course, the Ballarat boy who is going up to play with GWS to join Cliffo and the boys already up there. Now, talking about the Ballarat League... a very, very good story here, the one that we discussed the other week.
Yeah, it's an excellent story because on the weekend, of course, Bacchus Marsh defeated the North Ballarat team in the under 16 and a half grand final. It had a bit of meaning, didn't it, Sean?
It certainly did for Nathan Prince, who, of course, had got knocked to the ground, had a cardiac arrest and unfortunately died later on in hospital. His teammates rallied to the cause. They ended up winning the match for him. Dougie Hawkins said they'd win. They did it. Dougie's the coach. And it was especially great to see it. The Ballarat Football League has made a medal named after him for the best and fairest in the grand final. That was won by a Bacchus Marsh player and was actually presented by Nathan Prince's mum too. So it would have taken a lot of courage for her to get up there and present that award.
Absolutely. A great story. And Plough, you know Dougie really well.
Yeah, look, he was just shattered with Nathan's loss and just fantastic for the young boys to be able to get up. And the game was right on the line. And the other thing that I love was just how many people got along to support it.
Absolutely.
Yeah, people saying it was one of the biggest crowds they'd seen at that oval for a junior grand final, which is really good. And also credit to the Ballarat Footy League, who managed to get that medal and that award organised in a very short space of time. There's too many times things like this take 12 months or whatever, but the turnaround was really good, and congratulations to everyone involved in that situation.
Absolutely. Congratulations, all right. And well done to the... that's what the country people do. They just rally around.
Absolutely.
Now, let's have a look at some highlights from last weekend. And as I say, finals footy... always something good to have a look at. Where are we going to start? Let's go to the Bendigo League, Ross.
Let's do that. It's the second semi-final, and no surprises here. Golden Square, 43-point winners over Eagle Hawk, and straight through to the grand final for a chance at a third flag on the trot. Now, James Bristow was the big difference. He kicked 3 goals for the Bulldogs. 7 other individual goal kickers, including Grant Week, Simon Rosa and Jack Geary. The Bulldogs' star defender, Trav Baird, was involved in an off-the-ball incident. He ended up in hospital, but he'll be right to play in the big dance in a couple of weeks' time. Matt Gilmore kicked 2 for the 2 Blues, who had a terrible day in front of goals. He can't kick 3 goals and win a grand final, can you, Terry?
No, certainly. I mean, just 3 goals, 12 goals, 3, you're a chance in any game. But when you're kicking 3 goals, 12, you've got no hope.
And in the Hampton Football League, it was the second semi-final as well, where South Warrnambool, 21-point winners over Koroit. Scott Madden kicked 3 for the Roosters. He had great support from Miller, Kelly and Porter, who kicked 2 each. Now, Sam Dobson was the Saints' only goal scorer with 2. Captain Isaac Templeton was named best on ground for the Saints, and the gun midfielder and Hampton Interleague star Nick Thompson was best for South. Koroit will play reigning premiers Warrnambool in the prelim this weekend, and that'll sort out who's going to play South in the big dance.
The Koroit boys have always been a very successful team. I mean, they've been a wonderful team in and around that area.
Absolutely, for a very long time. Joey McLaren and those boys have been there for quite a while. Real dairy farming community, and just their heart at Koroit.
Well, certainly, tough footy. So who do we think is going to probably get the points? Warrnambool are going to be hard to beat again, surely.
I like Koroit this weekend, but South, I think, have got that flag wrapped up pretty easily.
Okay, well, we'll see how that all goes. Let's have a look at the Goulburn Valley Footy League now. Elimination final. Marutna to Tura. You want to talk about bad kicking, player?
At least you got the job done, but you've got a little bit of work to do before you come out next week. I mean, they go on Marutna and you obviously have another crack at it, have another opportunity, but 12-25, you're kicking at that accuracy in most games you're going to get done. They had Chitura covered very, very comfortably.
Who was the star in that game? Because there's some big names playing at Marutna, of course.
Yeah, Damien Uzay was fantastic, kicking 6 goals for the Cats, and Ash Hockey was the best on ground. Still, the Cats will want to improve because this, you can't do that in the final. And in an AFL match, it wouldn't have happened that way. You wouldn't have won the game.
And the Cats will play Shep United this week. And this is yours, Terry, up in the Ovens and Murray Football League. A 3-point win to the Pigeons in a classic prelim. Yarrawonga was 21 points down early in the last, but champion and former coach Craig Edney just turned it on, refused to lie down, reignited the Pigeons, and they got over the line for a pretty famous win in the end. Marcus McMillan kicked 4 for the winners. Joel Smith and Tim Cooper kicked 2 each. Now, that was Tim Sampson's last game as coach of
14
the Panthers.
Years.
14 years.
Yeah, 14 years. So look, that's a great performance. And a disappointing way to go out, but what a magnificent career regardless. And good to see the Pigeons going through. And the other one, Chris Hyde, I think, come runner-up, who I coached with Richmond, come runner-up in the best and fairest
Correct.
In the comp.
The Morris Medal on Monday night. Sean Daly, also from Albury, was first. So they had the Quinella there, which shows the depth of that side. And that was just a vote between first and second in the Morris Medal. So Albury, of course, already through to the grand final, and this Sunday that will be at Lavington Panthers
Oval. Watch out, the Pigeons are coming.
I was going to ask you about that. Is there any chance they can upset? Can they upset them or not?
No.
You know, they can't. Can
they can't.
Do you think they can?
It's been a great rivalry, hasn't it, between the two grand finals, two clubs, but they've got a bit of work to do still,
yeah,
I must say.
And Fargo's last game as coach, Albury wants that flag.
Did Spurs, did he coach with you? Or was he with Plough?
No.
With Spud. Not Plough. You are Plough.
I think I am, anyway.
And there's plenty more of Plough as well as we get to the break. Are you done now?
I'm finished.
I want to thank you because I always forget to say thanks, Shawnee. Another great job by you tonight, but did want to say that. But after the break, I should say, more from the list manager over here. Roz is going to stick around, and of course, it's a big show off the bench. And it's thanks to our great friends at McDonald's and the TAC. And at McDonald's, of course, the Shake of Fries, they're back just for a limited time.
It's time for the list manager for National Builders Group. More home, more value, more care.
Tonight we're having a look at Jordan Descent from the Sale Football Club in the Gippsland Football League. This key defender is a really good size for AFL football and was originally picked in the Peter Knight squad to represent his state but unfortunately got injured. Still a little raw at the moment, but just the right size for an AFL club just to keep an eye on him for a rookie list position.
Congratulations there to Jordan Descent. Descent from Sale, who, as you say, is a nice young player. Player, you've seen a bit of him. And, I mean, we've seen plenty of great kids. And we see plenty of great marks. There's talent kids all over the country. Just wanted to show you a little bit of vision from a great friend of the show, Darren Galley. This is his boy, Kane Galley. Have a look at this mark. Now, we're going to still this to the actual still shot here. But and that's young a kid. Mark. As I say, he's the son of Country Racing Victoria's main man, Darren Galley. And that's a beautiful mark. Anyway, a little bit of Dale Thomas about him.
Well, we like to throw him up there anyway, but he wasn't taking a chest mark. That is, honestly, that's a fantastic mark.
Yeah, well done to Kane Galley there, as I say, the son of Darren from Country Racing Victoria. Daz will be pretty happy with that anyway. Now, Rosie, let's get back to some highlights. And, of course, where else would we go when there's an upset in the Gippsland Footy League? Let's go to Mafra.
Well, this was a genuine upset because Sale had been on top all season, and now they're out in straight sets.
Any wonder with kickings like that.
Yeah, that's right. The 41-point win to Mafra in a straight sets exit, as I said, for Sale. Daniel Stubb and Jack Tatterson kicked 9 goals between them for the Eagles. Big Sammy Bristow was best on ground again, dominating the back line. Peter McFarlane was the best for the Magpies, with former North Melbourne Stewie Anderson kicking 3. Love, Martin and Davis kicked 2 each for Sale. Ooh. But they went in pretty undermanned.
Oh,
yeah, a bit of biffo. Good finals action. Sale went in pretty undermanned. Captain Matt Ferguson, excellent Kilder, of course, was out. And Shane Fife, Jamie Sweeney and Corey Scalty's all out as well. And they had a few more injuries on the weekend, so they had no bench by the end. Now, Mafra will play Druin in the prelim.
Can they win?
No chance.
What's going on with you, Russ? I mean, are you deliberately picking against your own team now? Because you picked them last week to lose.
Last year, I picked them to lose the grand final and they won it.
You didn't pick them to win last week against Sale.
That's right. I've tipped Sale and I've tipped Druin. And I've put Mafra about 60-1 to beat Druin at Warrigal this weekend. But, you know, I've been wrong before.
Are you well? Do they actually still like you down that way? Because
they used to
really love you.
When I keep saying things like that, they're not real happy with me when I head back into town.
Did I also see Young Butcher again played well on the weekend, the younger brother?
Yes, Danny.
Yes.
So what age is he?
He'd be 18, 19? 18, I think.
He's draftable, I think.
Yeah, he is.
He's draftable. He's one certainly to watch now. Well, let's have a look at some more highlights for the weekend. We'll start off with up around Geraldine, Billy Brownless territory.
Yes, we will. In the Bacola and District League Northwest Grand Final, it was Berrigan over Geraldine, which reversed the result of the second semi-final, which Geraldine had won. It was Berrigan led at every change in this game. 5-1 third term, proving the difference. Gerald Tower was best on ground. He kicked 4 goals for the Saints. That's right. He had great support with the Gorman brothers and Chase Saunders, who each kicked 3. Aaron Purcell kicked 3 for Geraldine. Dave Gregory kicked 2 and was the D's best, but a really good celebration there from the Berrigan boys. Very happy.
Just keep going on with it. Straight kicking. You get confidence.
Yeah.
I mean, if you kick them early and you jump out to a little bit of a lead, it gives you so much confidence.
Too right. Absolutely. And this is the Upper Murray League Grand Final, where Bullio were winners over Cudjoe. No surprises. That's 4 flags in a row now for the Bulldogs. 63-point win. They were the best team all year, so as I said, a pretty expected result there. Cudjoe were led by 3 goals at quarter time, but Bullio booted 7-1 in the second term and went on with it. In the Talangata and District League preliminary final, this one was. It was Kiwa Sandy Creek over Midi United. Now, the Hawks go through to the grand final, of course, and they will play Thaguna this weekend at Sandy Creek. Sandy Creek's the funniest oval you'll ever see.
Why is it funny?
It's a cow paddock, basically, for 11 and a half months of the year. And no one plays there all year, and they play the whole final series.
So they got a chance in the grand final, Sandy Creek. That's a pretty impressive victory.
It certainly is, but Thaguna has had a really good season, but you don't know in
grand finals,
do you? Yeah. That's right.
What we have noticed is there has been a hell of a lot of blowouts, and we don't want to see that. I love the close grand final. I mean, that's what we want to see.
Inaccurate kicking, as Terry mentioned, there's been a hell of a lot of that the last couple of weeks. So maybe the weather's had something to do with it, but we'll see how we go. A bit of a dry weekend predicted this weekend. So.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, that's good to know.
In part for the state.
The weather girl as
well. Yeah, well, that's right.
She's got it all covered.
We're in Perth, you and I. It's going to be dry there, trust me. Time now for the finest country football of the week.
It's time for the First National Finest Country Footballer, thanks to First National Real Estates.
And this bloke will be playing in the grand final this Sunday. It's Jay Kohler from the Albury Tigers. He's the fullback there, and he's a gun fullback in the top team in the O&M. He's consistently in his side's best players. He's a great mark and great skills on both feet. And, grand final on Sunday.
So he's in our team now. And yes. we've finally got a fullback.
Yes, that's it.
It's taken
it's
us
done.
To
well, I know, Spud's been on this. Spud's been ringing me just to push up the fact that we still need a fullback, and even when he can't turn up for the show. So it's been on all the time. And in all honesty, Albury, they're a fantastic team.
You want the Pigeons to win, but...
I'm keen on the Pigeons, but it's going to be tough.
Thank God. Well done to Jay. To get in. He's probably the last player we've picked now, is he?
I think he is.
Well done to Jay.
We'll be announcing, of course, our finest country footballer of the year next week.
Is Hutchie on the show next week?
Yes.
Oh, that'd be right.
Bad luck.
Grand final time. Hutchie just brings himself back into the team. Now, let's have a look at some great goals from last weekend's round of action. And where are we starting, Rosie?
It is Damien Uzay at Maroopna. Just swings around there. Terry, you must...
Nice goal.
Yeah, good player, good Damien. He's been a star in a couple of leagues over a period of time.
And Zach Peake, the dribbler in the Sunraysia Football League second semi-final. Yes, absolutely. Yes. And I'll tell you what, there was a massive crowd at that second semi up in Sunraysia last weekend. Really good turnout. And that was James Milne at Tatura. Unfortunately, the Bulldogs lost.
There was a touch of Stevie Milne about that guy, wasn't it?
And he's twice as good as Stevie Milne because he was wearing number 88.
Of
course, Stevie Milne wearing number 44.
Good pick up.
Very sharp tonight. Now, marks, and we always start off with a guy. This guy gets in the marks all the time. His name's Christian Height, and he's about 4'8".
He really is, but he's pretty solid. And he knows how to find the footy, that's for sure.
I shouldn't say he's 4'8", because he actually looked 4'9".
That was over the ruckman or the centre-half back. I mean, it was a big target. He had to get over.
That's right. And then this one, Matt Forey's in the Golden Valley. Yeah, Shep United. A great mark there.
Great work by the cameras there as well to pick that up. Let's have a look at Cameron Valentine here. Nice mark, Cloud, too.
Yeah, that's another nice mark. Just kept his eyes on the ball whole way. That's a really strong mark.
I was going to say, we normally go now to the funnies.
No funnies.
Got a lot of funnies last week, so we're going to go straight.
There's a lot of funny stuff
serious,
in grand final
finals.
Time. Yeah, exactly.
Well, I reckon there's always a little bit of funny stuff. I'm sure we can find it. We'll have to dig that up. Netball highlights time. No Sean Sowey to go through them. So, Roz, fortunately not really your forte, but what have we got?
Well, we've got the Central Highlands Netball League Grand Final. We're at a very close one here, boys. Hepburn by 2 goals over Warborough. It was a thriller. The sides could not be separated until the final whistle. After the final whistle, had to go into extra time for this result. So a really impressive game, and the crowd got their money's worth, that's for sure. Yeah. So undefeated season for Hepburn in the end, but gee, it went close at the end, didn't it?
Yeah, any spatial awareness, as Spud talks about every second week?
Oh, I would imagine so. It looks pretty chilly there, by.
But it's a good effort. I mean, when challenged in a grand final, when you've won everything over the course of the season, you can tighten up pretty easy, so the girls have done a good job.
Well, there was that sprinting onto the course. Yeah. Caught there with a bit of a hug and a bit of a cuddle.
Hopefully not just a hubby.
I hope it wasn't one of the husbands.
Ballarat Netball League, it was Golden Square by 2 goals over Santos. This is the second semi as well. So Golden Square, same result for the senior footballers as the A-grade netballers straight into the granny. And the Dragons, of course, have a second chance this weekend. They'll play Eagle Hawk for a spot in the grand final. The two sides had been sort of swapping first and second position throughout the year, so Golden Square first into the granny.
They're a strong club, Golden Square, aren't they? They are a great club.
It must be well administered because that's what the good clubs do. They keep all the stars, and they've got them in both footy and netball.
Once again, a great effort.
Well, Roz, that's you done for the day and done for the week, and I can't believe you've tipped against Mafra. That's actually really ordinary stuff by you.
Won't be heading back down there.
60-1, was that? 60-1, that's on record?
Yep.
So it'll be in the paper. Anyone wants to bet with Roz from Mafra, if they can get up this week, 60-1.
I'm actually going to the game, so if Mafra win, I'll cop it.
I'll tell you what now, the Butchers aren't going to be all happy with you as well. So thanks, Roz. We'll see you next week for the grand final. I think you get a Guernsey.
Yes, absolutely.
Of course you will. You're the star of the show. So coming up next, we'll wrap up the show, but all the action from the Loddon Valley Football League grand final, and we'll have a look at our big grand final show next week. This is Off the Bench, thanks to McDonald's and the TAC.
We've got good tall timber up forward. Let's get it in there quick.
Not one of you blokes is standing touch and feel.
He's leading you the footy all the time. Let's get in front.
Handball, handball, carry, carry.
Make sure we keep that pressure up. Attack on the footy straight.
It's just another test of character.
You must have every single bloke doing it that we know it's a golden rule. Correct?
Some of our famous sprays there. I love the ink work there on the big fella there.
Oh, it's a rev up too, isn't it? At this time of the year, I mean, you just got to nail those, don't you?
You certainly do. And we'll need to nail our show next week because we've got a big grand final edition show next week. Don't forget to tune in. All the highlights of this weekend's grand final matches, of course, the great goals, marks, We'll have some funnies. Don't worry about that, of course. And we'll announce the winner of the finest country footballer of the year. And not only that, present them with one of those really big checks for $5,000, thanks to our great friends.
$5,000?
At First National Real Estate. $5,000, a big check, player.
Mate, that's fantastic. And who's going to win? The fullback? Will it be the last one in? And if Spudder's got anything to do with it, will be. But I think we'll be sticking with the midfielder, sure.
My lips are sealed. I may know the winner. I may not know the winner as well. But we have got a little bit more action just to show you. The Loddon Valley Footy League Grand Final last weekend. It was a pretty good story too, player, because the Mean Machine were going back for back-to-backs. That's Bridgewater. What about Pyramid Hill? They thought they were a chance.
Yeah, they thought they were a chance. Didn't really get close in the end, but hadn't won a flag since 1950, so this was an opportunity to break a massive drought, but unfortunately, 40 scoring shots against them, it was never going to happen.
It wasn't going to happen. I mean, that's what you call game over. Nice and early, I would have thought. You played in a couple of grand finals, and we see the boys here, the Mean Machine. Look, obviously enjoying their win, and the coach was pumping the fist there and showing a little bit of guts.
Yeah, well, 6 goals to Brad Rowe in that game, and Dan O'Bree, 2 goals and best on the ground. Congratulations to those two guys who put in great performances.
Absolutely. Well done to Bridgewater there, of course, and well done to Pyramid Hill. You had a crack. Now, you weren't quite good enough, but you can stick in there. You might be able to do a bit better next year. Of course, you can follow the program on Facebook. Are you a Facebook man?
I'm more of a Twitter man.
Yeah, you're tweeting quite a bit,
eh? Yeah, I'm a list manager on Twitter, so that's my little go.
We can actually tweet this show, I'm pretty sure. Rosie, in the background there? Yeah, we can tweet it. We'll be able to tweet it, but Facebook's anyway. Facebook.com, off the bench, Vic, of course. Tweet the list manager.
At the list manager. Have a chat any time. And look, good luck to all those sides in grand finals this weekend, because it's a huge moment for the players, but also the country towns.
Absolutely, yeah. Good luck to the Pigeons. I don't think you'll beat Albury, but good luck anyway. Well, thanks for your coming tonight. We'll have a big grand final show next week. This has been Off the Bench, next to McDonald's and the TAC. Good night.